Hi guys, welcome to this video. Today we're going to take a look at Endeavor OS. Endeavor OS installs an Arch Linux installation and with a desktop environment of your choice. Let's get into it and see what by default will be installed on it. So let's boot into Endeavor OS. I found it very good to see an installer of Arch Linux and where you can choose your pre-installed desktop environment without any problems. The normal desktop environment for Endeavor OS is XFCE, but I now offer you an option for an online installer where you can choose your own desktop. So here we are at the live environment. I will check if I can already do something with my display. Yes, I can. Apply. So here we are. So normally they have this XFCE environment. So this is their default environment. But here we can choose to start the installer. Here's explained what they're doing. So the offline method gives you an XFCE desktop with Endeavor OS theming. And the online method lets you choose your desktop with a vanilla theming. So I will choose the online because I want to see if I would... my preferred desktop environment is GNOME. So if I would do a GNOME installation on Arch, I will have a very minimal installation. So let's see what happens when we do it like this, if this is a good option for an installer. So do an online installer, click OK. So now in the background, the Endeavor OS for the Calamaris is opened. So let's do it in English. American English, that's fine. Next. Yes, I'm in Amsterdam. My default desk, yes. So here we have the options to manual partition or do erase all disk. As this is a virtual environment, I'll do erase all disk. And the bootloader will be placed on the same disk. So let's forward this. I can set it to swap or no swap here. Let's choose swap, but no. Oh, okay. It crashed on me. Let's do it again. Online. Let's do it English again. Next. Amsterdam, yes. English, yes. Erase disk. Let's try and set it to no hypertension again. Oh, that's fine. So it didn't crash anymore. So next. And here there's the option for the desktop environment. So the base will be installed. What's in the base? Yay, Linux headers, Pacman contrib, Xorg server, GFS, account services. Let's see if something else jumps out. NVIDIA installer. Wireless tools. DTF fonts, Firefox, also utils, powerful control, bash completion, the welcome screen, Endeavor OS, that is good. So here we have the choices of desktop, so XFCE, Mate, KDE, GNOME, Cinnamon, Budgie, Deepin, LSQT, and those are the things that are there. So let's use the GNOME desktop. So in the GNOME desktop, what will be installed? GNOME, GNOME tweaks, Nautilus Sentoo. It's also a very nice one. Sentoo email or something like that. The GNOME NetTool, GNOME usage, MultiWriter, Het heet de Icon Team, GNOME Shell, GNOME Software Packages Plugin, GNOME Package Kit, Firewall, de Arc X Icon Team, that's nice, en de Arc GTK Team, so we can also already choose the Arc GTK Team. That's my preferred GTK Team, by the way. So, let's do next. Put in my username. Let's put in the machine name, password. Don't log me in automatically. Use the same password for the administrator. That will be fine for this installation. And click install. And install now. So yeah, it looks very nicely. It's the Calamares installer. It's installing now. I'll pause the video and I will see you when we're back. So the install has been done. So let's restart the system. So we're booting. And let's see what we end up with. Okay, so let's log in. So this is a nice question, changing the wallpaper. We change the wallpaper to Endeavor OS. Do you want to do that, yes or no? This is just a default wallpaper, so why not? So yes. So we now have the new wallpaper. So let me adjust the settings of the screen again. Apply. Keep the changes. Very nice. So let's see the wallpaper. So it's a very nice wallpaper. Would I use it as my default one? No, but it's looking very good. So here we have the welcome screen. It's also very nice since you have a welcome screen. On the first tab, you have the general info, so that's the website, news, donate, the wiki, the form, and about welcome. After installation, so we have a couple of options. This is also very nice. See you later with a nice thing. And don't show me anymore. With a nice teary emoji. But here are the first steps that you do after an installation. So let's go through it. So update the mirrors. It knows that I'm in the Netherlands. Include HTTPS. That's fine by me. Max hours from latest sync. 2. Short by rate. That's fine. Max number of mirrors. 10. That's pretty fine. So okay. Let's do it. And it gives me this new list. I only have 3 servers in the Netherlands, but that's fine by me. So save to etc.pacman.mirrorlist. Put in my password. And that's done. And now we click on update the system. Checking for updates. No updates available. So press enter. Detect package issues. Oh, that's nice that you have an option for this kind of things. So I would find a couple of issues. The NVIDIA driver, AMD GPU. So let's remove them. Put in the password. This is fine. And that's done. Endeavor OS to the latest. Now it should be already there. That's already done. change the display manager. It's not always that it gives you that option. So you can choose to do the LightDM or the LXDM or SSDM. But I'm a GNOME environment, so GDM is fine by me. I just cancel this one. And the Endeavor wallpaper, that's already done. And these are just some links to explain things to you for the use of. So if you want to use AUR and Yay, click on that. It opens a web page. And here are the things that you need to know about Yay. How to update stuff, how to install stuff, and that kind of stuff. So these are just some help things. On the third tab, we have add more apps. So you can install LibreOffice here, Chromium Web Browser, the Firewall, Bluetooth Manager from Accessory. But I'm not doing that at this moment, so don't show me anymore. So what do we have? We have the defaults here. So the default settings. So the start button, shutdown, the lock key, and the settings, the user, and the connection for your Wi-Fi or your wired connection, and the sound. In the middle, we have the calendar with the notification center. And of course, you can select your weather and add world clocks here. And on the left side, we have the activities. So here you can see all the open desktops that you have. Now it's only one, so that's fine. Activities, click on here, show the applications. So what is by default installed? These are just basic configuration files, books is installed, boxes, so for your virtual environments by default installed, the calendar is installed, cheese, your clocks, your contacts, document scanner, documents itself, files, this is Nautilus, still using the Atueta default icon set, about files, which version, 32-2, so that's fine. And they added the select folder, new folder. And here we have properties, move to. Okay. On the desktop, you can change the background display settings or the settings. Display settings. Let's go to the software again. Firefox is installed by default, HTOP, Icon Browser, Maps, Multi-Writer, Music, Network Tools. Click on Network Tools, let's see what this is. Oh, this is all the network tools that you can get. Package Updater, Packages. What is this, a Package Updater? What does it open? I'm not sure what that one is. Packages. Well, here you have a couple of things that you can use. So the GNOME desktop. Or you can switch to the KDE desktop. Accessory. So can be very nice. Photos, Pulse Audio Volume Control, Qt. Settings, Software Center. This is very nice. So they integrated the all the software repositories from Arch into the GNOME software. So if we go here and we go to the software repositories, so they have the community enabled, core enabled, Endeavor OS enabled, extras, multilib. The GNOME Shell extension, so it's also very nice that it always is enabled. Linux Vendor Firmware Services is enabled. So very good. So installed, you can see all your installed software if you want to remove something. I don't want a second, let's freeze it. I would uninstall web. If it would like me, if it would allow me, it doesn't. That's nice. But okay. And also the update, so you could update notifier when there is updates available. That's very good integrated. What else do we have? Software tokens, system profiler. I'm not sure what this is. Oh, okay, that's very nice. Request. Might be because I'm in a virtual environment, of course, but okay. So let's not click on system profiler again. text editor, to-do item, the usage, utilities. So these are all utilities like the archive manager, calculator, characters, disk analyzer. No tweaks. So disk analyzer, disks. What else do we have in here? Uxterm videos, weather, web, and Xterm. So, okay. Let's go into known tweaks, see what we have there. Because I saw that we have the Arc themes installed, so appearance. Let's go for the Arc Dark. Nice. Cursors, you can use the paper ones, and here we have the Arc XD. Let's open a file browser. So that already looks better than the normal Advaita's ones. Arch XD, Arch XP. What is it changing here? I'm not sure what the difference is here, but let's see in the icon set. Well, not much difference, I think, but okay. What else do we have? Paper and paper more not dark. Paper should be very fun, beautiful. Yes, look. And the icon set here is also very cute. So I would use it as this. Extensions, what is installed by default? Horizontal spaces, native minimum placements, user themes is installed. Let's enable it. Windows list, workspace indicator, fonts. Yeah, keyboard and mouse. That's fine. Startup applications, top bar. I would use the weekdays, I would use the week numbers. Title bar, here's where you can enable maximize, minimize buttons if you want them or not. I don't use it, but you can. Send to new windows, that's one I always use. And that's basically it. So yeah, it looks to me if you're looking for a very nice default installation of Arch Linux, without any extras, but just the basics and a nice integrated GNOME software with the Pacman of the Arch repositories. I think this is a very good system. Let's open a terminal and see what kernel we are running at this moment. 5.4, so this is the very latest one. Let's see if I have something like a screen fetch. Yes. So this is nice. You can see here that we're running the gnome environment 3.34.2, GTK teams, paper. So yeah, 879 packages. So that's pretty minimal. Yes. Let's run top to see how much memory really is used. Yeah, 646 megabytes of memory, 638, even it gets lower. So this is the real memory that is used. So yeah, hope you like this video, guys, and I will see you in the next one. Please hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the other one. Place your comments. Subscribe, of course. And have fun using Linux. See you in the next one, guys. Bye for now.